In this video, I'm going to show you how to insert tables, style them, and where tables are located in PowerPoint so you can include them in your presentation. So without further ado, let's get started. So go up here to insert, then you'll see here tables. You can then pick how big you want your table to be. It doesn't really matter how big you make it originally because you can always go back in and change it. It does help though if you do make it the size you actually need it to be right away, just so that you don't have to worry about changing how big it is. But let's just say I want my table to be, we'll make it 4x4 just to keep it nice and easy. Another thing to note is that you have these other options right down here. So right here you can type in how many columns or rows you want as well, and then you can hit okay, and that's also going to create a table for you. Or what you can do is you can go up here to tables, draw a table, and then you can get kind of funky with it. So if you want to make a little table icon right there, you can do that like so. And then another thing is, let's say you want to actually add in a table through Excel, you can do that here if you do Excel spreadsheet, and then Excel is going to pop open. And then what you can do is you can type in any information you want right here, exit out, and then it's going to show up in a table format right here. So another thing to note is that once you have this table selected, you're going to see a bunch of tools here for design and layout. So if I hit design, I can then hover over all these different designs. I can even hit this drop down menu and see what type of coloring or design I might like. I can sift through them. Maybe I like this one right here. And then I can also change the shading. So if I want this cell right here, or these two cells to be maybe orange color, I can do that. Or I can do a no fill, really mess around with that. I can also get rid of all the borders so I can have no border, or I can just have left borders. And you gotta make sure that whatever you're highlighting, that's what's gonna be affected. So since I was only highlighting these two cells, that's the only thing getting affected right now. And the rest of the table is just staying as is. Another thing you can do is effects. So you can actually add a bevel to your Excel spreadsheet. So if you see here now, there's a little bit of a bevel effect happening right here. You can also add a reflection. I'm not sure why you'd probably add all these bevels, shadows, and reflections to a table, but it is there for you if you do want to add those effects. I would probably just try to keep it as simple as possible just so people can just clearly read the table, especially if it's important information. And then let's say you're looking for a certain type of table style. You can select here what you're actually looking for, and then it'll populate here. So if you don't want a header row, it'll just make it like a normal kind of Excel spreadsheet, just every other. If you don't want a last column, it'll change that as well. Banded rows, it'll get rid of that. And you can just highlight over each one of these. It'll really show you what each one means. But that's how it's going to affect what table styles show here. Let's say I just want to add in some text. You can just add it in here, sample text. And then I can change this to be white. And so that's how you can add in text. And then you can also do quick styles. So if you want to change the styling of your text, you can do that here by highlighting it, and then you can change the styling of it. Not sure why you use these quick styles. I personally am not the biggest fan of them, but you can use them if you want. You can change the font color here as well. You can also change color of the outline of the text here as well. And then also if you want a shadow, reflection, glow, you can really play around with all these different effects. And then here's another thing to know is this draw borders. So let's say you want this line right here to be white. I would then go here to pen color, pick white, and then I can click right here, and then it's going to change that border to be white. Now let's say I want that entire line to be white. Click and hold, and then it will make that entire line white. You basically just have to draw what lines you want to be white by doing that, and then you can make it white. Another thing to do is, let's say you don't want to have to use this pen color tool right here. What you can do is let's say you have the color white selected, and then you want maybe all bottom borders to be white. As long as this color is selected as white, and then you hit bottom border, now it's going to make the bottom border of this table white, so you don't have to actually use the pen tool to make it white. So that's just another thing to know and a quick way to do it if you're not comfortable using the pen color option, which shows right here, can be a little bit finicky, so I would just recommend that. All right, so then if you click on this eraser functionality right here, you can actually erase lines quickly. So if I click this, this eraser appears, and then I can erase this line right here. Maybe I'll erase this line right here, and then that one right there. This is just a quick way to merge cell files together instead of having to right click and then do merge cells. So that's just another quick way to merge them more efficiently. You can also just right click, and you'll see a bunch of information here. So if you do do want more columns to the left, you can do that. More columns to the right. You can also insert rows above, or you can insert rows below. And make sure if you only want one row inserted below or above, just have your pointer tool clicked in on one row, right click, and then say insert rows above, and that way it'll just insert one. If you have multiple selected, then it will start to insert multiple rows above or below. All right, so that's everything within the design tab of the table tools functionality. But now if we go into layout, you'll see here's a lot more. So you can actually click the select and you can select table. It just selects the table. I really wouldn't bother using this functionality too much because you can do the same thing here. You can also delete columns. So if I want to delete that column, I can do that. Or if I want to delete the table, I could do that. Or even delete a row, I could do that. As you can see there, it actually deleted all the rows because I have all these rows selected. So if I only want one row deleted, I would just have my pointer in here and then I can just say delete row and then it's going to delete that row right there. Also, you can merge cells. So now all these are just one cell, or you can split cells and you can choose how many columns and rows you want when you're splitting the cells. So you can customize it here. So you just hit okay. And so now it's just two columns instead of one giant column. Next, you can affect the height and the width right here. So this is just a nice way to really affect how you want to manipulate the width and height of your cells. You can also distribute the rows and columns just so that they're evenly distributed. Next, what you can do is you can actually align the text. So let's say I have sample text. So for this alignment, right now it's aligned to the top, but let's say I want to be in the center of this cell. I can do center vertically. And then I can also center the text, and that's how you can put the text in the center automatically. You can also align it to the bottom. You can also change the text direction of this text as well. You can also change the cell margins. There's a lot of different functionalities here, so feel free to play around with them. You can really customize this table pretty much however you would really like it. I like to personally play around with just moving these lines myself. And then let's say if I want to just like have like a column hidden, I can make all these maybe like have no fill and then also like no borders. And that way it's going to look as if there's like nothing here. So let's say I click off. Now it looks like there's like a chunk missing out of it. So as you can see, you can really play around with this table just to make however you'd like, change it to be whatever color you'd like to match the theme of your slide. And that's really how you can play around with tables. If you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I do have a course available on Udemy. So I have a link to that in the description below. Lastly, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.